White-centered retinal hemorrhages, also known as Roth spots, are retinal hemorrhages that can be seen in a variety of medical conditions. Roth spots are most commonly associated with infective endocarditis and have been detected in 80% of cases of subacute bacterial endocarditis. This is a characteristic Roth spot. Originally described by Maurice Roth in 1872 while at the University of Basel, Roth spots were first seen in individuals with bacteriemia secondary to subacute bacterial endocarditis. The retinal findings Roth made in 1872 were described as round, oval or flame-shaped hemorrhages with a central white spot, as you can see in this image. However, it was not until 1878 that this condition was assigned the name Roth spot by the biologist Litten. Litten reported that these white-centered retinal hemorrhages had been detected in 80% of cases associated with subacute bacterial endocarditis, thus cementing the hallmark association. Historically, Roth spots were considered to be a pathognomonic finding to bacterial endocarditis secondary to septic emboli within the retina. However, Roth spots occur in many pathological processes, as you can see listed here. Roth believed this spot represented disseminated embolic foci of bacterial abscesses originating from infective vegetation on heart valves. Given recent histological data, Roth spots are now believed to be a result of ruptured retinal capillaries and intraretinal hemorrhage. A common thread found in these pathologies is a predisposition to endothelial dysfunction that allows disruption of retinal capillaries. Histologic examination reveals that Y-center lesions are composed primarily of fibrin, which represents a plaque of fibrin and platelets at the site of vessel rupture. Other potential etiologies of Roth spots are listed here. In patients that present with concerns for endocarditis and Roth spots, the clinician must carefully examine for other stigmata of endocarditis, including Janeway lesions, Osler nodes, and subangle splinter hemorrhages. Janeway lesions are irregular, flat, non-tender hemorrhagic macules located in the palms, soles, thenar, and hypothenar eminences of the hands and plantar surfaces of the toes. Always remember, it is not painful in nature. They typically last for days to weeks. Janeway lesions consist of microabscesses in the dermis with thrombosis of small vessels without vasculitis. They are usually seen with the acute form of bacterial endocarditis. Osler nodes are painful, red, raised lesions found on the hands and feet. They are caused by immune complex deposition. It is important to remember that Osler's nodes are painful lesions. Janeway's lesions are not. Splinter hemorrhages are small spots of blood coming from the damaged blood vessel that appear under the nail and they are become visible through the nail. The bleeding creates a splinter-like line in the direction of the nail growth. A thorough history should be taken with particular attention to medical history of previous infections and other history listed here. If Roth spots are found on routine ophthalmologic examination, referral to a primary care physician for evaluation and workup of the systemic disease is suggested. The initial evaluation is based largely on results of a thorough history and physical examination. The complementary tests that will be most useful for the differential diagnosis are listed here. Roth spots are most often asymptomatic and do not require ophthalmological treatment. Visual disturbance due to Roth spots is rare, but can occur with macular involvement. The most important management consideration in patients with Roth spots is the identification of the causative etiology to prevent possible ocular and systemic complications that may occur due to the underlying disease. Roth spots, also classically associated with infective endocarditis, are a non-specific ophthalmologic finding with multiple etiologies. Retinal vessel rupture with whole blood extravasation and fibrin plaque development in the site of the vessel rupture is the mechanism by which Roth spots occur. A thorough history and physical examination are paramount in diagnosing the underlying disease and guiding treatment in patients with Roth spots. If Roth spots are found on routine ophthalmological examination, referral to a primary care physician for evaluation and workup of systemic disease is suggested. Identification of the underlying etiology is important in patients found to have Roth spots, so that management can be guided to prevent any systemic or ocular complications that might occur. Roth spots are usually asymptomatic, do not require ophthalmologic treatment, and resolve with treatment of the underlying condition.